Deep in the woods lived an elephant, not the romping, stomping, enormous sort, but the prancing, dancing, happy-go-lass, who was full of smiles and razzmatazz. She would tend to the flowers, the plants and trees, keep the forest looking lush and green, and help her friends as best she knew. Everybody loved little Dassie for two. Oh, hello! Then, one fine day, Wast Elephant was trying to pick her favorite lunch. A cheeky, squeaky trickster mouse crept up and roared like a mighty lion. She leapt so high she reached the sky and landed with a thud and cry.
You couldn't scrape to my trunk, you fool. What kind of crazy mouse are you?
You're so big and I'm so small, you shouldn't be afraid at all. What kind of elephant are you?
Said the cheeky mouse to Dassie for two. But the hullabaloo had drawn a crowd, and all her friends were laughing out loud. Upset and confused, she wanted to cry, so Dassie for two decided to fly. Far, far away from the sniggers and jeers, saggy and sad and alone with her tears, she collected her thoughts.
I feel such a fool. Maybe I'm not an elephant at all.
From out of the trees crashed the matriarch queen, all trunk and tusks and pure elephantine. As she rumbled on by, she paused for a thought, as her eye caught her tooth, all slumped and forlorn.
But wait, what is wrong with this child? Why do you have such a frown in your crown? All this sniffling and sniffling, baby, what's got you down? 'Cause I'm wrinkled, crusty, voiceless, here's my thing. You can tell your troubles to Ophelia Bing.
I used to be such a happy-go girl, till a wee cheeky squeak blew the hair off my tail. And now all my friends think I'm stupid and daft. What kind of elephant is that? I hear them all laugh. Rumpin', stompin' is what I should be. Rumpin' in a moochie, babe, a matriarch queen.
Like me,
scared by a mouse, I should be ashamed.
Oh no.
Dassie Pertoo began howling again.
Rough mean and moochie,
cried Ophelia Bing.
Rumpin' and stompin',
yeah.
An elephant like me?
Yeah.
If that's what you want, then that's what I'll do. In six easy, easy steps, I'll make an elephant of you. Steps 1 to 3 is all you need.
Yeah.
To scare away your enemy, you gotta blow your trunk, flap your ears, stamp your feet, and show no fear. Only a fool wouldn't step aside when an elephant makes an angry charge. Have I given you a clue of what an elephant would do? Steps 4 to 6 is all you need to feast the prickly acacia tree. Never pluck with the trunk, as you better beware. To make a pot or two is a thorny affair. Tear out a tree, slam it on down, shake till the pots have hit the ground. Go ahead and try a few is what an elephant would do. There's one more step for the end of the day. When your stresses and strains need soaking away, breathe in all your troubles and spray out with love and dust away all that nonsense and blood.
Dassie Pertoo returned to the woods, and she romped and stomped like an elephant should. She pulled up the flowers and squashed the plants, uprooted the trees and stripped the bark. She grumbled and rumbled and bellowed and blowed, scared all her friends and messed up the grove.
You wench in a wolf in a woke in a wasp or a wolf in a woke.
Well, the withered old weasel. All Pertoo's friends were angry and mad. Behave or get out, you're destroying our land.
I'm a
a real elephant now,
said Dassie Purtoo.
If that's what you want, then that's what I'll do. Out there on the plains is where I should be, where the elephants roam, elephants like me.
Later that day, whilst Dassie Purtoo was plucking a prickly acacia or two, a growling snarl rolled from behind, but Dassie just laughed.
Why should I mind? Go away, silly mouse. I'm tired of your tricks.
But Dassie Purtoo was faced with a fix. Masavi the lion and his hungry pride glared back at Purtoo with a drool and a smile. These fandangled cats were no match for Purtoo.
Oh, think what a real elephant would do.
One step at a time is what she had learned, but her head was all muddled and fuddled with nerves.
Step one, blow your ears. Step two, flap your feet. Step three, stomp your trunk. Oh my, I feel sick.
The lions got closer and clink. When their claws, poor Dassie passed out, she could take no more.
Ba-da-boom, 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 ba-da-boom. Louder and closer came the ba-da-boom, boom. Brazen and brash, all muzzle and horns, charged Ophelia Bing and her buffalo bulls. They scuffled and brawled, scrapped and scratched. The lions all fled, they were troubled and smashed.
You've had a lucky escape,
said Ophelia Bing.
Messed up the forest and upset your friends. Don't ever pretend to be an elephant like me. You're different, that's all, and it's meant to be.
I'm wretched and rude, said a shamefaced Purtoo.
I should never have tried to be an elephant like you.
Dassie Purtoo returned to the woods, and she danced and pranced as a happy lass should. She was full of smiles and a carefree stride, and tended the plants with a careful eye. Never again did she leave her grove, or behave like a wasp and a whoppy and a woe. She lived in the forest as best she knew.
Every